Hey everybody, welcome back to the laboratory. I'm trying out my new little tripod here with the iPhone camera. So let me know what you think. The angle's a little bit weird, I think, but see, I have to, you see, I have to do that. But I'll get it worked out. Anyway, what do we have here? Okay, we have piece of sprue, okay, that we are going to cut like this. I'm showing you, for those of you who are beginning, possibly the oldest old school trick in the book, all right? It's basically the only way that I really know of making absolutely wonderful antennas and very thin, round pieces of styrene. You could use this for a variety of things, including making bolts. I mean, you name it. It's very easy, and I actually think it's fun. And why is it fun? Well, because it deals with fire, right? Here's my little candle. Those of you who are below the age of, 18, 12, 10, whatever, make sure you get parental supervision, okay? Or get one of your parents to do this, but I don't recommend it for people who have trouble with fire. Anyway... so let me do this and show you. Ooh, fire. I learned this back when I was, a teenager, from, reading a couple of books and, ooh, look at that. Happy birthday, Igor. Happy birthday, Igor. Happy birthday, Igor. Happy birthday to you. Anyway. Back. So basically, you're just gonna love this. It's so easy, and I need an antenna because I one of my buddies told me that the Merc needed an antenna with a dollar bill on top of it, and I totally agree. So here we go. What you do is you always cut it a little bit longer than the candle so that it holds it in place. Okay, and you're gonna see it. Basically, you have to keep rotating it because you want to distribute the heat. See how it's already bending? Okay, the thinner the styrene, once it gets shiny and glossy like this, it's ready. Okay, that means that it's melted. Now, check this out. You have to basically stretch it. Whoa, look at that. That just broke apart. So that, trial and error. I'm a little bit out of practice. And make sure you don't touch the hot melted styrene because you're gonna get burnt. So you let it cool for 1 minute. That's really the trick, and then you start pulling it. Okay. Oh, here comes there. It broke again. Hey, perhaps I might
need.
We're gonna get it right. We have cut more pieces of sprue. I'm feeling opera this morning, and let me move that there. Here we go. Come on. I've got a whole bunch of more pieces, longer pieces, thicker pieces. We'll see how it goes. But, I'm not giving up until I show you exactly how I'm going to make this antenna. And it's got to work. It's got to work, lovelies. Here we go. All right. You can see it's softening it. Oh. Move it away from the heat source. Keep stretching. Oh, this is, yes, Eureka. Woo! Okay, then you just turn it like that. And there we go. Stretch sprue. Yay! Nice. Finally. Okay, let me do another piece. Maybe that's what it is. You need longer pieces. Man, that took a while. Probably like 8 takes. Here we go. Come on, bend, baby, bend. And of course, you learn to do them thinner and thinner and thinner, and that's the beauty of it. and you could do them as thin as you want. And an antenna, you know, the antenna has to be. Oh yeah, see, that's how you get the hang of it. Okay, and you move it away from the heat source so that it cools. All right, you see it? See it there? Yeah. Now that's still, see, and once you know, it's a little bit flexible, but it's still a little thick for what I need. So yeah, you gotta keep trying, keep trying. Third time is the charm. Or maybe third time is the turd. I don't know. Huh. The turd. Okay. Now that you see me getting the hang of it, you'll see that it's a good 20 minutes worth of just melt it and pull on it. Come on, here we go. You feel the tension as you tug on it, and then eventually it stops wanting to stretch, and that's how you know you're done. Now, that's that's a little bit too thick for what I need. I'm looking for a very thin antenna. So I'm running it over the light and keep stretching, keep stretching, keep stretching. See, now it broke. All right, but you get the idea. You know, you can make it really thin. That's a nice thin. You can make bolts out of it, okay? But we're gonna keep trying here. We got a lot of video left. Hours and hours we'll sit here and get it done right. But sometimes you just have to stretch fast and furious just to get it thin enough. You're gonna see it here. I think, see, it's like, again, like barbecuing, roasting styrene. Here we go. Look at that. You can just stretch it. It's like magic. And I think I got it. I got it. I got it. Then move it, you know, just let it dangle there after it cools. And there we go. We've got our antenna. That's the thinness I want right there. That's a nice little antenna. And that's it, you know. That's a beautiful one. Let's see, maybe I'll do one more just because once you get the hang of it, again, you want to do several. And as I said, it's the oldest trick in the book. I guess model builders who make sail ships work like this. Imagine the frustration having to tie up all those sails and rigging. You know, but hey, they did it, and they did it. That's how they practice. Once you practice and you get it right, it'll do wonders. Here we go. Oh, that's, look at that. See? All right, we got it, and that's even thinner than the other one. This is the one I'm using. Yes, indeedy. Oh, I love it. Okay, so you know when you're done, when you have to blow out the candle and wish Igor again a happy birthday. Happy birthday, Igor. Happy birthday, Igor. Happy birthday, dear Igor. Woof, woof. Happy birthday to you. There it is, folks. All right. Sorry it took a while, but hey, this is how we all learn and practice. It doesn't come to you right away, but see, there it is. You're gonna see it next time you see this. It'll be on the car, and you won't even recognize it because it'll be painted in aluminum, and it'll have the dollar bill on top and a little watch part for the base. So anyway, hope you enjoyed it. Sorry it took so long to get it, but that's how it is. All right, later. In the house.